गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स। सो इन दिस क्लास वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट डायनामिक्स ऑफ सर्कुलर मोशन। सो योर पार्टिकल इज मूविंग इन अ स्ट्राइट लाइन और लीनियर मोशन, सो विथ और विदाउट एक्सटर्नल फोर्स। सो फॉर एग्जाम्पल योर फ्लोर, दैट इज आइस फ्लोर, सो इट्स मेड ऑफ आइस, योर प्लेस आइस क्यूब, सो विदाउट अप्लाइंग फोर्स द आइस क्यूब विल मूव इन अ स्ट्राइट लाइन। सो योर पार्टिकल कैन मूव इन अ लीनियर मोशन विथ और विदाउट एक्सटर्नल फोर्स, बट सो देयर शुड बी सम फोर्स एक्ट ऑन द पार्टिकल फॉर सर्कुलर मोशन। So a particle is moving in circle means there should be a force acts on the particle for a particle should move in a circle. So Newton's first law is not applicable for circular motion. So because the particle is at rest or uniform motion, so unless a external force acts on it, so here some force should act, then only the particle should move in a circular motion. So a force acts on the particle, that means the change the velocity of a particle in three different ways. So velocity is a vector, so it have both magnitude as well as direction. So first case, so the magnitude of velocity can be changed without changing the direction of velocity. So in this case, so the particle moving in the same direction, its velocity changes means acceleration also changes. Example, a bike moving in a straight road, so with acceleration, so by applying force its velocity is changed but direction remains same. So magnitude of velocity can be changed by applying force without changing the direction. So example, bike moving in a straight road with the acceleration and particle falling down. So particle falling down vertically means, so due to gravitational force its velocity changes, then so the direction of motion alone change. So the direction of motion alone change means, so here the particle is moving in circular, so the its direction only changes but magnitude of velocity remains same. So that is uniform circular motion. Then both magnitude and direction of velocity change, that is non-uniform circular motion. Example for that, oscillation of swing, then simple pendulum. So oscillation of swing, so this is a simple pendulum, both. So it moves like that, to and fro, it's not a circular motion. So oscillation of a swing or simple pendulum is example for non-circular motion. Then elliptical motion of planets around the sun. So elliptical motion, so ellipse, so planets moves around the sun, so it's a planet, so some exoplanet, so that may be a earth, so it's come under this non-circular motion. Here both magnitude and direction of velocity changes, so here the velocity also changes, here the magnitude also changes with respect to the sun. Then so as a centripetal force, a particle is in uniform circular motion, so there must be a centripetal acceleration towards the center of the circle. A particle is moving in a circular motion, so there should be a centripetal acceleration, it acts towards the center of the circle. So we have seen in the lesson number 2. So if there is an acceleration, there should be a force, that force is centripetal force. So using Newton's second law, force is equal to mass into acceleration, so we know the centripetal acceleration v squared by r. So just substitute, we'll get centripetal acceleration, that is centripetal force equal to mv squared by r. So centripetal force is also known as center seeking force. A force acting towards the center, that is centripetal force. Then centripetal force in vector form, so just minus mv squared by r, r cap. So r is a radius vector of a circle. So a force acting towards the center, so that r cap acts towards the center. So r cap represents the direction, the direction of a vector. So the centripetal force acting towards the center, so it's minus r. So that minus represents a force acting towards the center. So minus mv squared by r, r cap. Then we know the relation between linear velocity and angular velocity, v is equal to r omega. So just substitute, v squared equal to r squared omega squared divided by r. So you will get r omega square. So minus m v squared by r, instead we write omega square r, r cap. So it's a two form of that centripetal acceleration, so centripetal force. So in this class we will discuss so dynamics of circular motion, then centripetal force. So a force acting towards the center, that is centripetal force. Then formula for that, so minus m v squared by r, r cap. So that r cap represents the direction of that force acting towards